Thank you. Good afternoon. Your Union Redhawks. Don't forget, if you have friends and family who could not attend tonight's game, tell them they can watch live right now at unionsportsnetwork.com. First, let's meet the starting lineups for the Bixby Spartans. Batting first, playing shortstop, number 3, Cade Lewis. Batting second, playing center field, number 5, Cody Kroll. Batting third, playing third base, number 18, Brian Justice. Batting fourth, the designated hitter, number 10, Barrett Stanley. On the mound tonight and batting fifth, number 23, Jet Hope. Batting sixth and playing first base, number 1, Cohen Miller. Batting seventh, playing left field, number 13, Drew Gilliland. Batting eighth, the catcher, number 6, Brock Kopis. Batting ninth, the right fielder, number 2, Dax Sullivan. And playing second base, number 15, Rhett Liu. ladies and gentlemen, your Bixby Spartans. And now, let's meet the starting lineups for the Union Redhawks. Batting first, playing center field, number one, Gam Jones. Batting second, playing second base, number seven, Camden Knutson. Batting third, playing right field, number 23, Ben Flusche. Batting fourth, the designated hitter, number five, Dylan Baldridge. Batting fifth, the catcher, number 23, Steven Patterson. Batting sixth, left fielder, number 24, Braylon Danzy. Batting seventh, playing first base, number 10, Lane Wood. Batting eighth, the shortstop, number six, Cody Young. And batting ninth, playing third base, number three, Zach Oliver. And on the mound tonight, number 25, Armando Gomez. Your assistant coaches are Chuck Justice, Jeff Brown, and Brendan Alizaris, and your head coach is Sean Newkirk. Ladies and gentlemen, the Union Redhawks. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, if you would please rise and remain standing as we honor America with the playing of our national anthem. Dotson. I'm your announcer, Jim Douthat. Ladies and gentlemen, it's time for Red Hawk Baseball. And with that, kids, we welcome you in. Woo! Take a breath, everybody, because if you didn't see what happened last night, I will figure out a way to tell you about the link that John Dotson has so you can see the play at the plate, the double play that ended it. And Union came away with a 2-1 victory last night. Ben Flusche with the catch him, throw him out kind of double play after Cam Knutson came in and threw two pitches, Pete, is that right? Two pitches to close the game out. But tonight, Bixby looks to redeem themselves. Let's face it, both teams right now are tied at 8-3 in this district. They're one team's 20-7. That would be the Bixby Spartans. Union, 14-13. Union 3-2 in their last five. Bixby 2-3 in their last five. So comparisons all around with the exception of the overall record. And folks, strap in because it's going to be a good one tonight. Alongside Kyla back there, Andy Irwin, Jerry sitting to my left, scoreboard operator here, John back there spinning tunes, which you can hear sometimes if YouTube doesn't cut it out. I'm Jim Douthat. Thanks for joining us here. We're looking for a good one tonight. Defensively, you know it. Setup hasn't changed very much for Coach Newkirk. Braylon Danzy in left, Gam Jones in center. Ben Fluché, the hero from last night, in right. Oliver at third, Young at short, Knutson tonight at second, and Lane Wood at first. Your battery, Armando Gomez and Steven Pattison. And here we go. Leading off of the Spartans, the shortstop, number 3, Cade Lewis. Woo. The defending state champions getting ready to look at Gomez for the first time for them, and he'll right down the middle, called strike. Your umpires tonight, David Summers, Andy Bruner, and Billy Shafi. I know David pretty well. David and I played hockey back in the day. He's standing over there at third, so I'll get to rattle him and give him a hard time, but I'm not too sure Billy and Andy, to be honest with you. So 1-1 from Gomez. High, just over the head, and it's 2-1. The one thing that we'll see in Gomez, the last time we saw him pitching here, he was working fast. He struck out 9 batters in a row and then was pulled. We were hoping for some sort of record, but popped up straight back towards us and just out of play. So 2-2. Beautiful night, a little windy. We expect the wind to change, but I'm not too sure if that's going to happen during game time or not. Right now it's blowing in pretty hard. 17 miles an hour, according to our meteorologist, Pete Knutson. Thank you, Pete. So a full count from Gomez on Cade Lewis, the shortstop for Bixby. As I said, a 2-1 game tonight. We're expecting a little bit of the same as Lewis fouls that one back, and we'll do it again. Lots to talk about this week. Soccer Friday, baseball Friday as well. We'll bring you soccer action. I'll talk more about that. We'll bring you soccer action right here live on the Union Sports Network. Senior night here Friday night as we honor, goodness, 11 seniors? Like Jerry's supposed to know, 12. I was going to say 12 originally, and there goes Cade Lewis, strikes out, swinging. What were you going to say? Oh, that's right. Yeah, because Jackson will be here. We'll honor him as well. Center fielder Cody Kroll. So a strikeout, the first strikeout victim tonight is Cade Lewis. Cody Kroll, the center fielder, steps in. Gomez delivers, just miss on the outside part of the plate. It's 1-0. Back up the middle. That'll be a base hit. Nice piece of hitting there by Kroll. And Bixby's got a man on. Third baseman, Brian Justice. An opportunity for Union to turn a double play. They did it. How many times last night, Pete? Three times. We'll see if the defensive prowess continues for the Red Hawks tonight. Gomez checks on the runner. Runner fakes going right down the middle for a strike. So Kroll dancing around there at first just a little bit. Gomez gave him a look and decided to come home. Kroll again with a little bit of a lead. Dances out again, way out. Snap throw down to first. Not in time. Boy, Kroll got a little too far out on his skis, and Pattison almost caught him. Nice job by Kroll getting back, though. Pattison kind of gave a long stare back down to first again as he got back down and behind home plate. So it'll be interesting to see how this battle continues. Now Gomez over. So 1-1. the count to Justice. Gomez takes a little bit longer look. Now he's set. Gets the pitch he wants and throws over again. It's one of the beautiful things about Gomez is typically how quickly he works. And he can throw some BBs. If there's one thing that I'd say about his game is his throw to first is a little slow, if you will. That's what I want him to do right there. One and two. So the 1-2 from Gomez, runner goes, hitting, little hit and run action there, squandered off. Justice didn't get all of it, and we'll do it again. So Pattison will go out and have a quick conversation with Gomez, make sure their signs are correct, I'm sure. Gomez gets set after a quick conversation with Patty. Kroll with a nice lead, struck him out. Justice reaching for that one. Armando fooled him on a change, and there's two away. Designated hitter number 10, Barrett Stanley. So Stanley, the lefty, steps in. Crowding home plate is Stanley. Gomez checks on the runner, and he comes home. First pitch swinging, and it's fouled out of play. And right towards some cars. We had a windshield on a Cadillac destroyed last time here, we heard. Alex's mom's windshield? Got it. Well, she was sick that night trying to watch from over there as Gomez throws over to first, not in time. She got a lot sicker after that ball hit her car, that's for darn sure. So have we set up a GoFundMe page for Alex Wood's mom's car yet? No? Okay. Just checking. Didn't know if there was anything I needed to announce here. Gomez, the 0-1 delivery, swung on. Wind is going to carry it a little bit, hold it up there. Jones way underneath it, and that'll retire the side. Cody Kroll gets a single, but that's all that happens for the Spartans. We head to the bottom of the first. Union coming up.
At Coldwell Banker Select, we have the group to meet your commercial real estate needs, the Select Commercial Group. David Roberts can answer all your questions relating to the commercial real estate market, your business operations, and real estate budgets. Sarah Bergeson can help you locate the right commercial property to buy, sell, lease, or rent. Scott Job can provide valuable information regarding property values and lease rates. We treat our clients like family. With properties located all over the state, call us at 918-695-6979. Coldwell Banker Select Commercial Group, proud sponsor of the Union High School Redhawks.
Thank you. back live here on the Union Sports Network. Leading off, center fielder Gam Jones. So Gam comes in. Batting 373 on the season. First pitch swinging fouled off. But I finally have the stat to back up what I say every single game. He turns singles into doubles because he's got 33 stolen bases this year so far. So you know when Jones is on, he's looking to run. But he's got to get on first. 1-1 now to Jones. Foul the first one off. Takes the second pitch high. On base percentage just over 500 for Jones. And that'll be high too, and it's 2-1. So from my understanding, what I'm hearing is Jed Hope, this is his first start in quite a while after he had a little elbow issue. He pitched 11 or so pitches on Friday. Is that right, Pete? Yeah. Pitched 11 or so pitches on Friday. And 11 strikes. So the Bixby staff says Hope's good enough to go, and he'll go now. 3-1 to Jones. Just outside, and Jones is on with a walk. We'll see if they test the arm of Copist, who's behind home plate. Next up, second baseman Camden Knutson. So Knutson steps in with a runner on first. Defensively, Gilliland in left, Kroll in center, Sullivan in right. Justice and Lewis on the left side of the infield. Popped out of his glove there. Jones will get back. So Justice at third, Lewis at short, Lou at second, and Miller at home. And Hope and Copas are your battery for the Bixby Spartans. Gam with a nice lead. Hope looks over at him. Everybody knows the speed of this kid, and he'll scramble back. Nice move by Hope to get the throw to first, but it's not time. Again, a little bit closer that time. As Hope's trying to time it just a little bit. Jones with the gig lead, and they're going to get him. Throw down to second, and they're going to say it's a balk. Yep, so the balk will be charged to Hope, and Jones will stay safely at second. The Bixby head coach not happy with the call, but apparently there was a little bit of an issue last night. But it's a different crew tonight, so it really doesn't matter. So Jones stands safely at second. Hope wants a new set of signals, and he'll get it as Knutson steps out of the box. Again, Jones with a big lead. Dancing around out there, fakes going. And it's high 2-0. And just like that, they're going to have a quick conversation on the mound. So while they have a meeting on the mound, we'll take a quick timeout. Nothing. We're sitting here in the home half of the first. We've got back live after the meeting on the mound. Jones back to second, Knutson back to the box. Counts 2-0, as you can see right there on your screen. Hope will have to come home as nobody's covering second now. And it's high 3-0. So the 3-0 from Hope. Right down the middle, 3-1. Now look over at Coach Newkirk and see what he's going to put on here. Knutson batting 313 coming into tonight. Everybody fakes like they're going to second. Hope looks back one more time, then he comes home. Almost hits Knutson. It'll be runners at first and second. Right fielder, Ben Fluché. So you walk two batters to get to Fluché. Fluché is batting a hot. Hot's the best word I can think of it. 500 right now. With an on-base percentage of 571, and I'm wondering if they want to pitch to him at all, as that will come across the plate for a strike. Jed Hope tries to right the ship. So Jones at second, Knutson at first. The hot-hitting Fluché at the plate. The 0-1 delivery on the ground. They'll go to third just in time. And a nice play by Lewis to Justice to get the lead runner. Hit right to him, nothing he could do about it. Designated hitter, Dylan Baldridge. All right. So with one away, Baldridge steps in, batting 355 on the year. Knutson at second. Fluché at first, on the ground again. They'll get it to second in time, throw to first, not in time. So they'll get Knutson at second. Fluché at second. Thank you, Jerry. Get Fluché at second. So runners at first and third. Baldridge is safe. The catcher, Steven Patterson. Patterson swinging a hot bat right now. So with your lead runner 90 feet away, see what he can do. Nice pitch there, a little breaking ball action. It's 0-1. So two grounders to the left side of the infield and Hope's one out away from getting out of this inning. That started with two walks. Hope's fakes to third, then back to first. Everybody stays home. Patterson steps back in the box. Blew it right by him, and it's 0-2. That was some heat from Jet, that's for sure. Sizable lead by Baldridge. He goes, swung foul, and Baldridge will have to go back to first. So the 0-2 coming to Patterson. Danzy, if we get that far safely in the on-deck circle, he would be up next. Fouled off barely. And it remains 0-2. So the 0-2 coming to Patterson. Baldridge goes just a little low. I'm not too sure how Patterson laid off of that one. The Bixby fans are not happy. The 1-2. Oh, that was a makeup call. So Patterson will get rung up there. Union gets two on, but comes up empty-handed. We head into the second. 0-0. Bixby coming up.
When summer heats up and your AC isn't working right, be cautious of being pressured into a replacement.
It's always a good idea to get a second opinion, and Airco will let you know if your AC is worth fixing.
So call Airco today for a free second opinion.
Back live. Bixby's half of the second. Leading off for the Spartans, the pitcher, number 23, Jet Hope. So Jet Hope steps in. A little shaky early on in the first inning for the Spartans, but got a couple of ground outs and was able to get out of the jam that he got himself into. First pitch from Gomez was apparently a little inside and low. Pitch number two, right back at us. I think I even flinched just a little bit. And it's 1-1. Little high, 2-1. So the 2-1 just miss. And I think that's what Patterson held it there for an extra millisecond to be like, I think you just rung me up on that one, Blue. So. The 3-1 foul back and it's 3-2. Hope swinging a big bat. Nice cut out of him. Full count to Hope. Pop straight back again. And we'll do it again. On the ground, Young ups, throws in time, but Hope was scooting down that first baseline. That was a little bit closer, I think, than Young expected it to be, but there's one away. First baseman, number one, Cohen Miller. So with one away, Miller will step in. Don't forget, Union Public Schools and the Union Athletic Department wishes to thank Advanced Orthopedics of Oklahoma, our sports medicine provider, for all district sports. And just like that, it's 0-1. The 0-1, high, 1-1. The 1-1, just missed. Patterson tried to frame it up for the home plate umpire, but it's just outside, 2-1. Popped up. Jones heads back, gets underneath it. There's two away. Yep, not quite the crazy track that Jones took the last time he caught a fly ball out there off Stanley's bat. He went out, came back, all over the place trying to figure out where that was going to land. Left fielder Drew Gilliland. So Gilliland comes in, nobody on, two away. Gomez. Gilliland tries to bunt himself on and bunts that thing all the way to the Bixby dugout. Got to say hi and good luck to not only Nick Irwin, but my son Darian Douthat as they're rooting for the Capitals tonight. A little hockey action. The Capitals win and they make the playoffs. They lose, they are not in the playoffs. So everything on the line for the Caps fans tonight. Nick, I know you'll enjoy that one while you're grading papers. The 0-2 delivery. Gomez shakes off the first sign. Struck him out. So strikeout number 3. Gomez is feeling it. We head to the home half of the second. Not at 0.
It's also a base company that can get you the quality you deserve at unheard of and unmatched lead times. Talking 2 weeks or less, not 2 months like most others, and can do it as much as 60% less than most of the big guys out there. So join the likes of Sand Springs, Union, Broken Arrow, Jinx, Ooliga, and Glenpool to name a few, and get your customized sublimated uniforms, including Under Armour, Nike, or Adidas at InkwellNation.com.
Back live here on the Union Sports Network. Leading off the left fielder, number 24, Braylon Danzy. As Danzy steps in, Hope back to the mound. First pitch is across there for a strike. Talking a little bit about, let's talk with Pete and Andy over here about arm strength and where you're releasing the ball and that kind of thing. And I was talking the fact that this is Hope's first start after his elbow issues, and wondered, the conversation led to, you know, the motion between a quarterback and the motion between a pitcher, very, very similar. but you're not hearing, you rarely hear, I should say, Tommy John surgery for any kind of quarterback, even elite quarterback. So that's what you may have heard just a little bit as I was bringing the mic back in. The 2-1 delivery is fouled straight back here, 2-2. 6-7-8 due up for the Redhawks. Danzy Wood and Young. Danzy, 368 on the season. Just over 400 as an on-base percentage. That's high. Danzy works the count full. Fans come alive a little bit. That'll ring him up. Pitch right down the middle. Danzy was taking it all the way, it looked like, and they'll ring him up. Strikeout number 2 for Jed Hope. First baseman Lane Wood. So with one away, Wood steps in. First pitch swing, and that'll find a hole. Base hit for Wood. And Union with one out's got a runner on. Shortstop, number 6, Cody Young. First pitch down the middle. Young coming in with a .243 batting average. Hope looks over at Wood now. Back set, comes home, and that's lifted to center, to the gap. Way back, the wind, and he drops it. Kroll can't come up with it. Jeff Brown will hold up Wood at third base. Kroll had a long way to run. He had his glove on it, but couldn't track it in. And that'll be a double. And runners at second and third with only one away. Third baseman Zach Oliver. So Kroll had a long way to run, and that showed some great athletic prowess for him, but he just couldn't make the grab. And I'm wondering what the conversation was like between him and Gilliland, because I think Gilliland had an opportunity. He didn't have as far to run, but I don't know if he actually saw that ball off the bat, because he did get a late jump to it, and Kroll did not. So regardless, it's second and third, and that's a ball on outside as Oliver pulls the bat back. We'll see if Newkirk's going to try to generate a run with a little squeeze play here. Speedy Jones on deck. Oliver again lays it down, bunts it foul, and it's 1-1. Interesting. Well, if Hope knows that's what he's going to do, I'm sure that Oliver's going to get a pretty good dose of fastballs right down the middle and make Oliver get that bunt down perfectly. That's what I expect out of Hope here. Jerry's wanting him to swing away. Oliver again. And that's just a little low, 2-1. Whew. Tight strike zone for Blue. 2-1 coming up to Oliver. Oliver looks over. 1 foot in the box, 1 foot out of the box, and now he sets. Hope already had its pitch, waiting on Oliver to get in the box. Gets the bunt down, foul. Be 2-2, I think that. Went off the plate and kind of carried him back this way. So Young at second, Wood at third. And the 2-2 coming from Hope. Swung on, back up the middle. That'll be a base hit. Crawl in. One run will score. Here comes the throw home. Safe! Oliver comes up huge with a two RBI single. And Union goes on top. 2-0. Jerry, you wanted him to swing away, and he did. Maybe you need to get down there and get off the scoreboard and get down there and do a little coaching. No? Do I need to shut my mouth? Fair enough. Next up, the center fielder, Gam Jones. I do have a hot mic, and it's okay. Listen, everybody can be critical. Ba-dum-bum. First pitch swing, and Jones straight back at us. We'll do it again. 0-1. Oliver was off with the pitch, so a little hit and run action going now for Newkirk. That's a very good crowd. Bixby always travels well. Good fan base, good group of parents. So. 0-1 over. Trying to get Oliver leaning just a little bit was Hope. Oliver will be back safely. Knutson on deck, so one away. Jones led off the game with a walk. Then reached second on a balk and thrown out at third on a routine ground ball. So that's been Jones's night. Caught a couple of nice fly balls out there in center as well. Runner goes, throw down, not in time. And Oliver with a stolen base. It's going to be the ninth stolen base for Oliver on the season. One more away, he's got double digits. So the double play out of play now for Bixby. And that's on the ground. That may find a hole, and it does. The Speedy Jones are going to test the right fielder. The throw comes home, not even close. Sullivan. So Lou makes a stab at it. He can't get it. It bounces off his glove and all the way to Sullivan. By the time Sullivan gets to it, he's up and throwing, and the throw was way off the mark. And it's an RBI single for Gam Jones. Second baseman, Camden Knutson. So Knutson comes in, another walk victim in the first. And Hope throwing it right down the middle for a strike. Let's see if Gam can pick up steal number 34 right here. Big lead. Ooh, breaking ball. That almost snuck back in over the plate. Sure brushed Cam back off the plate. Regardless, it's 1-1 now. Runner goes. Pitch inside. He's not even throwing. Kind of double clutched it with Copas. And Jones with base or with stolen base number 34 on the season. So 1-2. The count now to Knutson. Swung on, and that's out to the left center. Gilliland with the play, and there's two away. Right fielder, Ben Fluché. So again, an opportunity for Union to still do some damage. Hot hitting Fluché in here with 2 outs. Jones at second. That'll be inside for a ball. 1-0. Union again this year has done a pretty good job getting some runs across with two outs. Jones goes looking for steal number 35, and that'll fall. Ooh. Wow, got away from Justice. I think everybody thought it went to the left field. That was almost a little closer at third than we needed it to be. Stolen base number 35 just happened for Jones. Now Hope comes home. That'll be on the ground to second. Lou up, throws in time. But Union puts up a three spot. Big crooked number for Armando Gomez, and he'll jump back on the mound when we come back. Top of the third right after this.
Racing towards the end of the month? Ask about our early pay options. TTCU Federal Credit Union. Life is better in balance.
Back live here on the Union Sports Network, Bixby coming up. Leading off for the Spartans, the catcher, Brock Copas. So Copas steps in. Armando Gomez back to the dish, and it's just outside 1-0. So Broken Arrow right now is on top of Piedmont, 1-0. Why is that important? Well, look at the district standings. Go to OSSAA.com and you can see all of it. Go to the left side, you click on districts, and you can pull up 6A and see all the district standings there. Gomez, 3-0 now. So for the first time tonight, I think Gomez has gone 3-0 to a batter from Bixby. A 3-0 delivery, and it's high, and they walked him. So Copas comes up with a walk, and I'm sure they're going to bring in a courtesy runner. So we'll see what happens here, and they do. Well, they got a kid out there that's running, but I don't have his number on there. I believe that's 19. Well, regardless. Right fielder, number two, Dax Sullivan. So Sullivan will step in. Pinch runner in for Copas, drew the walk. Just on the outside part of the plate, and it's 0-1. As I look over my score sheet, I don't have a number 19, so. Welcome to the game, number 19 for Bixby. Take a big lead. Swinging 0-2. They have blooming onions here? Sorry. I just heard blooming onion from my right over here. I mean, Briggs, Hayworth, you guys didn't have blooming onions. I'm just saying. This group of parents got it going on. I was going to say that. The 0-2. That's going to get down. Danzy over. Oh, nice one-handed grab. There's going to be a play at third. Not in time. And a base hit for Sullivan. And Bixby's in business. Took a funky hop on Danzy, but what a great play for him. He barehands it out there to get it in. If that gets by him, that's definitely a run for Bixby. That'll bring in the top of the order. Shortstop, Cade Lewis. Lewis steps in, bunting all the way. Tries to lay it down, throw it down to first. Second, I mean, not in time. Nice piece of running there by Sullivan. Got a good jump on Patty, and Patty just couldn't get it down there in time. So Lewis struck out his first time up, back in the first. First of three strikeouts for Gomez. The 0-1 delivery. Strike number two, Patty with a nice stop there. So the Spartans threatening here in their half of the third. Nobody out, runners at second and third, and two strikes to Lewis. Gomez delivers just outside Patty with another nice block. One and two now. Little eye, 2-2. Don't forget, coming up this week, Jinx Trojans come across the river to take on our soccer club. That'll be Friday night, girls at 6, boys at 8. Coverage right here on the Union Sports Network with Nick Irwin, and another strikeout by Gomez. Looking. So whatever Gomez is doing to Lewis, that's two strikeouts for him. And that'll bring in center fielder Cody Kroll. So along with soccer Friday night, boys will have their senior night here. So come out and join us at the ballpark. As Gomez offers up first pitch ball to Kroll. Kroll had a base hit back in the first, so he's one for one. Just outside. 2-0. And that'll be in there for a strike, 2-1. So 2-1 to Cody Kroll. Runners at second and third. Gomez, the wind, the delivery. Got him, 2-2. Thank you, Eli. So the 2-2, struck him out. Strikeout number 5, Cody Kroll. And Eli, as he's walking out of the press box, scared the crap out of everybody in the section right in front of us. Third baseman Brian Justice. Wish there was a way to get that on camera. Gomez, first pitch, swinging, and it's a strike. Justice swinging for the fences. Man. Not too sure why he went all the way out to the mound. Did you see anything there, Jerry? That? Oh, did it? Okay. Caught Patty kind of weird. Just misses one and one. Yeah, Eli, you got it, buddy. So the 1-1 to Justice popped up, foul, just out of play. Justice, another strikeout victim back in the first. So he's 0 for 1. One, two. Got him. So after a walk and a base hit, Armando Gomez says, you'll get nothing and like it. Strikes out three in a row. Six on the night for Gomez. Union on top, 3-0.
The right way to top a sub is with real red wine vinegar made from red grapes and no food coloring. And the right way to film it is in slow motion. Obviously. Because authentic ingredients make a sub above.
So while you were away, Cooper Leggett comes in to take over for Jed Hope. And that's inside. And I believe, Jerry, you told me that Hope moved out to center, correct? Yeah. So Hope will now be at center. And if there's any more defensive changes we can figure out, we'll let you know at home. Leggett, 1-1 now to Baldridge. Baldridge reached on a sacrifice back in the first. Just over his head, it's 2-1. Leggett gets the sign. Big leg kick, and that's on the ground. And that'll get through. Lewis made a diving attempt at it, but he couldn't come up with it. And the leadoff man's aboard. Catcher number 23, Steven Pattison. So Patty will step in, struck out back in the first. We'll see what kind of play Newkirk puts on here. So he steps in. Home plate umpire telling Coach Newkirk to let's go. Signs a little faster, please, apparently. Leggett 1-0. Patterson squared around a bunt there. We're going to see if he does it again. He will. High. 2-0. Patterson with a good eye right now. Leggett. Again, trying to find his spot here. Leggett looks over. Patty squares up. They come home, butt bumped straight up in the air. Pops straight up, and that's one away. No advancing there. He got just underneath it just enough that Leggett could get off the mound quickly. And there's one out. Left fielder, Braylon Danzy. So Danzy steps in. Again, Baldridge at first after a nice base hit. They'll throw over, try to get him, not in time. Cooper Leggett, sophomore, is a big kid. A lot of leg. We'll do it again, try to get it over. Just missed. Baldridge scrambled back and got a fingernail in there. He'll throw over again. Almost got him that time again. Leggett with a nice throw over to first. Baldridge again. Not quite as far the lead this time. And a la T.J. King style, Leggett's hat's come off his head like, I don't know, six or seven times already. Brings back some good memories of King being on the mound for us. I'll throw over again, not close this time. Baldridge a little wiser to Leggett's throw over, pickoff play, if you will. Three nothing. Baldridge at first. Danzy steps it home. And it's 2-0. Popped up. Hope underneath it. Tracks it down, and there's two away. First baseman, Lane Wood. So Wood, one for one tonight, came in, got a base hit back in the second, part of that three-run inning for the Redhawks. He was a big part of that. Runner goes, and another stolen base. So they're going to know something about Copas. Seems like a lot of folks are running on him tonight. So the 0-1 delivery coming from Leggett, fouled off 0-2. Throw down to second. Nobody was even close. Baldridge got back anyway. Imagine coaches telling Leggett right now, just come home. It's 0-2, get two outs. It's interesting what may be going through Leggett's head right now. The 0-2 delivery. Down the first base side, foul. So a big gap in right center as Sullivan is playing not too far off the line. Runner goes, and that hits him. Wood wears it. Runner gets down to second, but I believe he's going to have to go, or excuse me, down to third. Yep, he'll travel back to second. So it'll be first and second for Cody Young. Shortstop, Cody Young. So Young doubled back in the second. He had squared around a bunt two or three times and then pulled it back, and they finally let him swing away, and he roped a double. Runners go. And no throw down again, and Baldridge channeling his inner Gam Jones, wants a piece of that 35. Okay, let's not get too far out on our seats. So Baldridge, let's see the stat line on Baldridge and stolen bases, Mom, Dad. That's number eight. That's number eight. A little shy of Gam right now. Let's see if Wood takes off. So Leggett, the big sophomore, steps in, comes home in the dirt. And yes, sure enough, Wood with a stolen base. All right, yep, if you're scoring at home, Wood has got, that's his first stolen base, ladies and gentlemen. Lane Wood with his first stolen base of the afternoon, or of the year, comes at the expense of Copas and Leggett. So second and third with two outs. Outside 3-0. The walk chants come from the student section. The 3-0 delivery from Leggett. Just inside, and he'll load him up. They'll load him up. And that'll bring in third baseman Zach Oliver. So Oliver, with two RBIs back in the second inning, has an opportunity to do the same here. Roped a single back in the second to score two. And now with the bases loaded, he'll get another opportunity. They'll have a meeting on the mound. We'll take a quick timeout. Union on top, 3-0. Back live, Zach Oliver, as I said, checked in. So the conversation up here in the booth is the fact that Leggett is so slow and cumbersome to the bag. He's throwing. I mean, he can flat flamethrow the ball in. But he's so slow to the plate. It gives everybody an opportunity to take off, and that's low and inside, 1-0. Here will come the Bixby coach. They'll have another meeting. We will take another timeout because that's what we do here. We're live. Union up 3-0. Back line, the meeting on the mound is over. Leggett remains on the bump. The 1-0 delivery coming from him with the bases loaded. In there for a strike. Zach Oliver. Opportunity to bust this wide open right here. On the ground. One hops, throws to first in time. So Union will strand three, but they'll stay up 3-0. Bixby coming up.
We're athletes.
Coaches.
And your child's high school athletic trainer.
We're your friends and neighbors.
And we make
our home in Green Country.
We're Advanced Orthopedics of Oklahoma.
And we're the team positions for more universities,
more high schools,
and more club teams
than all other providers combined.
We're focused on providing you
personalized orthopedic care,
treating the area's best teams,
and the athlete in all of us.
Back line, Bixby coming up here in their part of the fourth. Leading off the designated hitter, Barrett Stanley. 4, 5, and 6 for Bixby. As Gomez back to the bump, first pitch swinging. Oh, and a diving catch by Knutson. Oh my. One step to his left and he grabbed it. Web gem, ladies and gentlemen, for sure. Dad's hoping he didn't break the sunglasses. We'll figure it out, Dad. Center fielder, Jet Hope. So Hope steps in. That's in there for a strike. It appears, Pete, his sunglasses are fine. That's in there for a strike, and it's 0-2. I was going to say, he's rubbing that shin pretty good. I'd be more worried about the shin right now than I would the sunglasses. Are they Oakleys? Oh, okay, you got insurance for that. I'm sure you can buy insurance on glasses, sunglasses anymore, much as those things are. There you go. The 0-2 popped up. Jones is going to co-hustle. Oh, and what a play! What a great play there by Young. Young kind of a basket catch there. Jones was on it all the way. They kind of collided out there a little bit, and we'll see if Young coming up a little limp. Now he's stretching himself out, and we'll see. I think as he caught it, he saw Jones and tried to get out of Gam's way, but regardless, there's two away. First baseman Cohen Miller. And a couple of great plays so far defensively by Union in this inning. And that'll get scored as a pop out to short, but nice run there by Young to flag that one down. That's just inside, 2-0. I think with the fact that Miller's crowding the plate just a little bit, you would think you would have got the call there. The 2-0 outside, 3-0. For the second time tonight, Gomez is 3-0 to a batter. And they're for a ball, apparently. Okay. And Miller will be on with a walk. At this point and how well your defense is playing, I'm going to say just that, go out there and throw strikes and let your defense do what they've done here in this two-thirds of this inning, that's for sure. Left fielder Drew Gilliland. So Gilliland steps in. Miller at first. Took a big lead. Now he jumps back. Now he jumps back out. Looked like he's playing Frogger, and that'll get fouled off 0-1. So Miller stands at first. Gomez winds, throws. That'll get down the right field side. Tailing foul, thankfully. And a long strike, and it's 0-2. As I watch in between pitches, Young continues to squat over there at third. Touch that left hip a little bit, so we'll see what happens there. That's outside. 1-2. Young is kind of gimping a little bit. Oliver's him are talking right now, and that'll be a strike down to first, and that'll be it. So another strikeout recorded for Gomez. Bixby gets a man on but can't do anything with it. We head to the home half of the fourth. Union on top, 3-0. Beck live here, home half of the fourth. 1, 2, and 3. Leading off for Union. Leading off for the Redhawks, the center fielder, Gam Jones. So Leggett back to the bump. Jones' first pitch swing and fouled off. And it's 0-1. Oh, 1 delivery way outside there, 0-2. Or excuse me, 1-1. Hello. Math. I know. Outside again. 2-1. Misses outside, 3-1. We'll see if Jones is taken all the way here. Make Leggett throw it across the plate. Swinging 3-2. You wonder how long Bixby's going to let Leggett go. But again, they used one pitcher last night or two? Yeah, Bixby did. Yep, that's what Jerry was saying. So they've used one, they've used two tonight. And that's the left. Nice job there by Gilliland. Can kind of get the sun out of his eyes, and there's one away. Second baseman Camden Knutson. So Knutson in. First pitch swing and fouls right back at us. Tonight he walked in the first, popped out in the second. Hit the ball well, but defensively came up with a huge play in the top half of the fourth to rob what was easily a base hit. Part of a quick inning for Gomez. Really two web gems that inning. Knutson's great diving catch and then the basket catch made by Young as he was running back, and that'll wear it. Knutson will wear that one. Might have hit him right in the old tush. Dad said he's been working on his glutes. That's maybe why. Right fielder, Ben Fluché. Fluché steps up. Reached on a sacrifice in the first, grounded out to second in the second. 0-1, runner goes, throw down, got him. Knutson trying to get a piece of the stolen base action, and he gets thrown out. So the 1-0 delivery coming to Fluché, now two outs for Leggett. And that was a gift. That's on the ground. Gobbled up by Justice. And Union goes in order. We head to the top half of the fifth. Union up 3-0.
Get on! Get on!
Back live here, Gomez back to the mound. Copist, the catcher for the Spartans, leads it off, and it's 1-0 to him. Don't forget, as I mentioned, Jinx Trojan soccer. Friday night, girls at 6, boys at 8, right here live on the Union Sports Network. Join Nick Irwin. The 2-0. Down the middle, 2-1. So the 2-1, 2-2. Again, a good crowd here tonight. Weather is just about perfect, and I believe that wind has finally died down a little bit. Yep. Look at it, treetops out there is. Beautiful greenery is really starting to settle in here. And that's it. Another strikeout. And that's strikeout number 5, 6, 7, 8 for Gomez. Gomez is feeling it. Right fielder, Dax Sullivan. Coming up on 7:30 here, Central Standard Time. Thanks for joining us. First pitch swinging, that'll be a base hit. Shortstop, Cade Lewis. Gomez, snap throw down to first, not in time. Gomez tried to get the breaking ball to break, but it didn't break at all. Patterson had to jump up to get it and then snap throw down to first, but all that for nothing. I'm going to say a steady dose of strikes right now, as well as your defense is playing behind you. Let him go. Runner goes. Bunt gets down. Gomez over. Can't field it. Throw quickly there. Got him. Now they got him in a rundown. The throw. Ooh. Not in time. So a lot happening there. Gomez can't come up with it. Oliver quickly down to first to get a great play by Wood and Oliver for that matter. And almost got Dax Sullivan on a rundown, but all that for nothing. But there is two away. Oliver, a great job by him to back up Gomez. I think Gomez was looking at first before he tried to field the ball, to be honest with you. Center fielder, Cody Kroll. So Sullivan in scoring position at second. So what was crazy about that play is that Wood had to get the ball quickly over to Young, who was covering third, but Young was shielding his eyes, and we've talked about the sun before. So I'm not sure if Woody put as much mustard on that ball as he wanted to in the event that he would throw it into basically left field. So a lot happened there regardless. Defensively, the boys are on it right now.
baby. The final last down.
The 2-0 delivery coming from Gomez. Fouled off 2-1. Yeah. So a 1-5-3 put out for Gomez. Andy asked if he touched it. Jerry said he did. So if you're scoring at home, Linda Blythe, Becky Blythe, 1-5-3. And the other few hundred that are listening out there.
Twin, what?
Soccer's playing Sands Breeze right now.
Twin.
Bro.
We're playing Big Twin.
Patty out to have a quick conversation with Gomez. He'll come back.
Hey, Big Z, take clear. Hey,
and the 2-1 delivery with two outs coming from Gomez right here. Runner goes, throws high, throw down. Boy, and threw that into right field, or left field, excuse me. And that'll score a run. And Oliver couldn't see it, and that's what he's holding his hands up. He's like, I never saw it. And again, there we go, talking about the sun. If Patterson gets that throw on the money, I guarantee he's out. But a throwing error to Patterson, and that'll get the run home. So now 3-1. Swung on, that's out to right. Fluché back, way back, way back, and he'll make the play. So one run will come home after an error from Patterson, the throw down to Oliver, and Oliver never saw it. But we'll head to the home half of the fifth, Union up 3-1. Back live here, home half of the fifth. 4, 5, and 6. Two up for the Red Hawks. Leading off for Union, the designated hitter, Dylan Baldridge. So DB steps in. Baldridge, as I said earlier on, batting 355. Leggett, big throw home, and that's across for a strike. It sure seemed outside. The 0-1. Swinging 0-2. Swung on, lifted to center. Back is Hope, and there's one away. Next up, the catcher, number 23, Steven Pattison. Thank you, Linda Blythe, for the shout-out on the tie. She said Les Nessman. I'm good with that. The first pitch swinging, and it's just foul. So for you kids at home, Les Nessman was a famous reporter on WKRP in Cincinnati. Cincinnati, there you go. And so look him up. If you want to watch the funniest episode ever, find the Thanksgiving special and the free turkeys. That swung on. That'll be a base hit. And you saw justice there affected by the sun. So Patty gets on with a base hit. Courtesy running, Mishan Miners. Now batting, number 24, Braylon Danzy. So Pattison, his throw down to third, got affected, scored the run, but he gets the benefit of the sun now because Justice can't see it. I think Justice, all he had to do was jump, and he probably would have got it. Miners is over there, back quickly. So Mishan getting some quality playing time here as of late. Pinch running. So Minners with six stolen bases. We'll see if he gets an opportunity, and he can't. Throw from Hope, not in time, boy. Great job from Hope in center field, and he got Minners scrambling back to first, but he's back safely. And that'll bring up first baseman Lane Wood. Wood denied base hit in the second, then hit by a pitch in the third. Inside for a strike, 0-1, I should say. Wood asking home plate umpire, where was that exactly? He obliged and we're back to playing baseball. Minner's barely back in time. Leggett with a beautiful throw to first. So Minners again with a bigger lead. Just a little bit more he's trying to get. He does. That's on the ground. Picked up by Justice. Throws to second in time. And Union strands one. We head to the sixth. Union up 3-1.
Stop trolling, bro.
Miners.
Show Miners. trolling.
Hey, bro, stop trolling.
Hey, Chris, stop trolling, bro.
Hey, Ma, stop.
Stop trolling.
Ma, tell your man stop
trolling. Back live here. 3-4-5, due up for the Spartans. Leading out for the Spartans, the third baseman, number 18, Ryan Justice. Justice steps in. Out of town scoreboard brought to you by Texas Roadhouse. We understand that Broken Arrow just beat Piedmont. 1-0, is that right? 1-0. So the Tigers out in Piedmont, is that correct? Yeah. Oh, at Broken Arrow, got it. So Gomez again, back to the bump, 1-1 delivery. That's in there for a strike, 1-2. Tonight for Justice. He's 0-2 with two strikeouts. That's on the ground. Gomez quickly off the mound. And over to first in time. Wood with a nice job to stretch it out there for the 1-3 putout. The designated hitter, Barrett Stanley. Stanley steps in, popped out back in the first, and then lined out to Knutson in the fourth. One of two fantastic defensive plays for the Redhawks in the fourth inning. The 0-1 from Gomez. In there for a ball, apparently. That's what Patty turned around and asked home plate umpire, maybe where was that? The 1-1, swung on, Knutson back on his horse. He can't get that one, and that'll fall safely in for a base hit. So a soft kind of bloop play out there, and hit it in no man's land. Knutson made a run at it, but couldn't get a handle on it. Center fielder, Jet Hope.
Cody, you play twice, man. Hey, B, what's up? That's all you.
Hey, CB, what sauce you got?
Home plate umpire let me know that there's a courtesy runner, and if I had his name and his number, I'd be more than happy to answer.
That's the weird sauce.
I got the pink sauce.
That's the weird sauce.
That's that pink sauce, right?
I got the pink sauce.
That's Miss Pinkerman.
First pitch swinging and it's 0-1. For Hope tonight, he grounded out in the second, popped out in the fourth, so he's 0-2. Had a great defensive play for the Spartans in the home half of the fifth and almost doubled up Minners after a great catch out in center. Gomez will check on the run. Now he sets up, looks for the pitch from Patterson. And the 0-1 comes home. And Hope just swings at nothing out there. I'm not too sure what he was swinging at there. But I'd go ahead and bury one in the dirt right now. Runner at first with a little bit of a lead. Gomez with a long look home. Now he sets. Patterson sets up outside, and it's in the dirt. I think I just said that. Hope doesn't chase, though, like we hoped he would. Thank you. Thank you. The 0-2. Swung on, and that's roped out. That's going to get down all the way to the wall. One run will score. The throw comes in. Not in time. And a big RBI double for Jet Hope. And this game just got a little more interesting. So after Gomez had Hope just guessing at just about everything, Hope comes up with a double off the wall. First baseman, Cohen Miller. Gomez will ask for a bunch of new signs, and now he asks for Patterson to come out and talk to him. It was a quick one. Just outside. To Miller, don't forget, like I said earlier, Friday night. Jinx Trojans take on your Union Redhawks. Over on the pitch, girls at 6, boys at 8, right here live with Nick Irwin on the Union Sports Network. 1-1. Then if you want to get out of the house and come on to the Bell Ball Field, you can catch senior night right here as the boys take on Booker T. Washington. That game starts at 6 as well. So the 1-1 from Gomez. Back up the middle right at Gomez, and there's 2 away. Boy, I thought that was lying to him. I guess it obviously was a ground ball, popped right to him. Yep, went off the ground. But nice job by Gomez. He thought about going to second. Nobody was there to cover it, so he gets the sure out at first. That'll bring in left fielder Drew Gilliland. So Gilliland tonight, another one that struck out twice. Two of the 8 strikeouts, I believe, Gomez has thrown. That's in the dirt. Another nice job by Patty. I'm telling you what, nothing gets by that kid. Yeah, 8 strikeouts so far for Gomez. So Gomez with a long look home. Hope stands at second. The tying run is at second. Another good stop by Patty. And it's, let's see, 2-0 to go. And there for a strike, and it's 2-1. Runner goes, pitches just outside. Patty can't get a hold of it. And even Oliver was telling him to eat it. So Hope now 90 feet away represents the tying run for the Spartans. Gomez with the 3-1. Comes home, popped up. Long run, Fluché's over there, and they get out of the inning. Woo, not before Spartans put another one on the board off a double by Hope. We head to the home half of the 6th. Union coming up.
Just hit the ball. Yeah! Or as they say, let's get that ball and roll it!
Me and Zach.
Home half of the six. We'll welcome you back to the Union Sports Network. 8-9-1 due up for the Redhawks. Leggett back to the mound. Leading off for the Redhawks, your shortstop, Cody Young. So Young steps in. First pitch swinging, that's roped out. That's going to get by Gilliland. That's all the way to the wall on a ground rule double, as Gilliland came in on it and then had to quickly scamper back. And Young, first pitch swinging, and it's a double. And Young is having himself a game. 2 for 2 with two doubles and a walk. Third baseman, Zach Oliver. We'll see if Young, what pitch Young goes on here. See how aggressive Newkirk wants to be. Copas has got to know that runners are going to go. Lewis is shadowing Young right now. And that'll be thrown into center field, but Hope with a nice job to get over there and cover. And Hope's got himself a cannon. So nobody goes that time. It was very interesting. Kind of looked like this was football. That'd be something out of Barry Switzer's book right there. All the razzle-dazzle he used to do for the Sooners back in the day. And try it again. In there for a strike. So Young off of second. Lewis again, right behind him. Lays down the bunt. Leggett looks at third, goes back to first. They say they got him. They got him by a step. But it doesn't matter. Young is over safely at third. So some insurance, 90 feet away now for the Redhawks, and that brings in your center fielder, Gam Jones. So the speedy Jones. Leggett almost looked too long at third and barely got Oliver scampering down to first, but there's one away. It's just inside. 1-0. Infield is in. Be interesting if they send Oliver. Or excuse me, send Young, I should say. But all of Bixby's infielders are on the grass. Just outside, 2-0. Hey, what's that ingredient? The lemon pepper. What's that song? Whoa. 2-0, way outside, 3-0. Knutson stands on deck. Leggett with a long look in. Now he sets. 3-0 in there for a strike, 3-1. You okay with that, Dad? No. So now the 3-1 coming to Jones. Lays down the bunt. It's a good one. They're going to let Jones get in there safely. No throw at all coming from Justice. So it'll be first and third. Second baseman Camden Knutson. So we'll see what Coach Newkirk pulls out now. Some speed at the corners. And Jones and Young. Kopis has got a good throw down, but Leggett's got such a slow, methodical kind of stretch to home plate. We'll see what Coach Newkirk dials up here. Remember, only one away. Knutson tonight, 0 for 1, got hit by a pitch. Now throw over and try to get Jones to stay close. Again, Knutson 0 for 1 tonight, got hit by a pitch back in the fourth after Dad said he'd been working on his glutes. Again, Leggett trying the fancy stuff. Fake to third, fake back to first. Jones again with a nice lead. Inside, and that'll hit him. Again, another hit by pitch. And that'll load the bases. And no, sir, he has not been working on his biceps. I saw him. You can't get away. Glutes I'm fine with, Mr. Knutson. But I'm not saying he's working on the biceps. Yeah, he's been working. That's fair. Well, there'll be a meeting of every Spartan player that they have on their roster, apparently. At the mound as Leggett will come out. They'll change pitchers. We'll get some warm-ups and let you know what they changed it to. Union bases loaded, one out when we come back. Back live, new pitcher. Now pitching for the Spartans, number 9, Kamen Franklin. So Franklin, a junior, coming in relief, trying to stop the bleeding, if you will. Right fielder, Ben Fluchet. Ben comes in with the bases loaded, loaded. As Ron White would say, one out. And high and inside is the first offering from Franklin. So with one away, these are the opportunities that Coach Brown and basically all the coaches have talked about. Can't leave these runners on base in this moment. In there for a strike is Franklin, and it's 1-1. Got to get at least one run out of this, if not more, with only one away. With your bases loaded. Franklin, that's out to center. Not shallow enough, or not deep enough for Hope to throw home. Got him. Catch him, throw him out. Reminds us of last night and what Fluché did. But Hope with the cannon, and he's fired up. So Union leaves, well, two on. Three on, well, I got to throw out at home, but sure. Leaves the bases loaded, if you will. We head to the seventh. Union up 3-2. Hi, everybody. Back live here. Top of the seventh. Great throw moments ago from Hope after he caught it and threw it home to save the run. We head to the top of the seventh. 3-2. Union on top. And yeah, let's be honest. This is exactly what Union did last night to end the game against the Spartans on a great throw from Fluché. Patterson got the tag down. So here we go. Gomez back to the bump. And it'll be 8-9-1 for Union, or excuse me, for the Spartans. Leading off for the Spartans, number 14, Grant Goldman. So Goldman checks in, first time at bat tonight. First pitch swinging, popped up. Long run for everybody, but that's going to be well out of play. Gomez will get a new ball from Patterson, and we'll do it again. So the 0-1 to Grant Goldman. On the ground, up the middle, that'll be a base hit. So a base hit by Goldman. And that may bring in the right fielder in Dax Sullivan, and I believe it will. Courtesy running for the Spartans, number 8, Brooks Dixon. So Dixon will come in and run. Gomez is gonna be done. Great job by Gomez, and it should be a good hand from the Union faithful. He struck out 8. Allowed 6 hits. Knutson will warm up, and he'll try to close this one out as he did last night. We'll bring you that when we come back right here live on the Union Sports Network. Sean,
just positions, right?
Back live here on the Union Sports Network. So officially, Knutson will take over on the mound. Gomez will move to third. Oliver will move to second. Now pitching for the Redhawks, number seven, Camden Knutson. Now batting for the Spartans, number two, Dax Sullivan. So Sullivan steps in. Dixon is the courtesy runner at first. Knutson throws over not in time. Stabs at it. That'll be a strike. 0-1. The Briggs family giving me a hard time for calling the old Booster Club parents out for not having blooming onions. Let's set the record straight. There are no blooming onions here in the concession stand, as far as I know, at the field here. Great food still. Cannot take anything away from the food that we serve here. It's mighty good, but for the record, I don't want everybody coming thinking they're going to get blooming onions here at the ballpark. So, there you go. Back to baseball. The 1-1 coming from Knutson. Sullivan swinging that back like crazy. Popped foul, and it's 1-2. Sullivan wants that one back. He is juiced up. Knutson going to have to work a little harder tonight than he did last night. He came in relief and threw two pitches. Dixon with a little bit of a lead. Knutson slowing it down just a little bit. They'll throw over again. Dixon, not too big of a lead. We've seen a lot of players have a much bigger lead than that. And Knutson trying to keep him close, though. Throw home just outside 2-2. Get the Orioles-Twins game on. Kind of neat to see a player who was played on this field just a couple of years ago now in the big leagues for the Orioles, and that's none other than you guys know, Jackson Holliday. So kind of neat to see him getting his opportunity as that's out to right. Fluché on the run. He can't make the play, but everybody will hold up. So what Fluché couldn't do there, he did keep it in front of him. So it'll be nobody out, but runners at first and second. That gets by Fluché, and this game is probably tied. So defensively, you'd love to see Fluché make that catch, but keeping it in front of him is huge because he laid out And now with still with nobody out, the tying run is in scoring position for the Spartans. And Cade Lewis steps to the plate as the Spartans have turned their lineup over. Stab bun on it, and it's foul. So Wood letting Gomez know to stay at third. Wood saying he's going to try to cover all that ground between him and Knutson and Patterson. They're going to cover the ground so they can try to get the lead runner. So they're telling Gomez to stay at home. So Knutson with a long stare home gets his pitch, he sets. Wood crashes. Knutson comes home. And another tip strike, and it's 0-2. Now we'll see what we're going to do here. Lewis will probably swing away at this point. Wood still on the grass. Popped out. Fluché with another long run. He makes the grab. Woo! Fluché kind of hesitated on that and then turned on the Jets. And he, man, boy's been busy the last couple of games. Great job, Fluché. And there's one away. Center fielder, Cody Kroll. So Kroll's gonna step in. Base hit back in the first, struck out in the third, popped out in the fifth. 1-for-3. And he pretends like he's gonna bunt. It's 1-0. Knutson comes home, pop foul. He's 1-1. Knutson sets. The 1-1 delivery coming from him. Popped up. Danzy over. Makes the catch and there's two away. Woo! What a big out. Danzy saw that the whole way. Jones, the way Jones started off on that ball, I thought that was all his. Danzy waved him off quickly. Because he only had to take about 15 steps to his left. Third baseman, Brian Justice. Union one out away. And everybody will be safe. Interesting play there. Gomez couldn't come up with it. The chopper the way it was, but it was a good job for Young to back him up. The bases are loaded. Designated hitter, Barrett Stanley. Stanley comes in, popped out in the first, lined out in the fourth, and then got a base hit in the sixth, so he's 1-for-3 tonight. Tying run, 90 feet away. On the ground foul. That's 0-1. As I said earlier, Knutson having to work a whole lot harder tonight than he did last night. Knutson up for the challenge, though. Nut, 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 The 0-1 delivery. Swinging, strike two. And Knutson and the Redhawks one strike away from taking two games from Bixby and moving into first place in their district. Time will be called now. We'll pause the dramatic music. Everybody take a breath. We're at it again. The 0-2 delivery, everybody running. Just outside. You probably heard the groans from the press box. The umpires in the press box said it was over the plate, but the one that counts said it wasn't. So 1-2, and we'll do it again. Stanley, Knutson, threw it outside on purpose, 2-2. Deuces across the board. Knutson comes home. Pop, foul. Stanley doing a good job staying alive here for the Spartans. Cam again with a look. He sets. And that'll get down. A base hit, that'll score one. Throw home, that'll score two. And Bixby goes on top, 4-3 on a base hit by Stanley. And that'll bring in center fielder Jet Hope. Patterson will step up and set up the defense. So runners at first and third, though. Knutson's got to slow it down just a little bit. And courtesy runner coming in is Rhett Liu. Courtesy running number 15, Rhett Liu. So Liu will come in. Patterson will go out and have a conversation with Knutson. And it, was it a broadcaster jinx? Did I speak too early about getting one out? One strike away from being in first place. I don't know. Send those mean tweets to me at Red Pen Thoughts on the Twitter, formerly known as the Twitter, now the X. I'll read those mean tweets on the air next time I'm on the air. There you go. How about that? Now Rhett Liu's going to come out of the game. I was wondering because he had started and different courtesy runner as the.
You can do that?
It's going to be number 10 this time. So. Barrett Stanley. So it's interesting with them changing the pinch runner like that twice. Now the home plate umpire will come over and have a quick conversation with Coach Newkirk about that. It's the first time in a long time I've seen two different courtesy runners coming in. No plate umpire down there to explain it to Coach Newkirk and Coach Brown. lot of conversation now between everybody. Now another one of the coaches is going to come over and have a conversation. Spartan coach. So whatever was explained to Coach Sean Newkirk, he's going to let it go. And a long delay while we sort all that out. Center fielder, Jet Hope. So Hope can definitely help out the cause as everybody goes. Barrett ran. Knutson knew not to throw down a second. Wasn't a big deal. Because the most important person that's in this game right now sits at home plate. He's wearing number 23 for the Spartans. In the dirt. 1-0. Fouled off, 1-1. So I talked earlier about the play at the plate last night. If you guys follow Ashley Fluché on Facebook, that's where you're gonna see it. So she posted that last night on Facebook. As that's on the ground. Great diving stop there by Young, but no play. And that'll score another run. So another base hit and an RBI. And now the Spartans are on top, 5-3. First baseman, Cohen Miller. One strike away. Did Blue miss it at home? I'll let you guys rewind it and decide on your own. The feeling is in the press box is yes. That's way out to right. Fluché back, and he makes the grab. Another great defensive play by Ben Fluché, but Bixby gets three. We head to the bottom of the seventh. Union down by two. We head to the seventh. 4, 5, and 6 due up for Union. Plenty of opportunities for Union to get out of that inning, but a missed called strike, a couple of base hits, and Spartans jump on top of Union there and score three. Franklin back to the bump for the Spartans. And that's lifted out to center. Hope comes in. Now he's got to go back. That's going to get over his head. Baldridge in with a leadoff double. And a great start there for Union as Baldridge ropes one. Hope came in, and then he had to change directions, and he had to quickly get out there. But even if he would have taken a direct line on the ball, I'm not 100% sure he would have caught it. Catcher number 23, Steven Pattison. So Patty tonight, 1-for-3, struck out in the first, popped out in the third, but had a base hit in the fifth. The lone hit in the fifth inning. But all we need is a base runner at this point. Oh, and a big cut there by Pattison, and it's 0-1. The 0-1 delivery. Foul, and it's 0-2. One of the faithful listeners out there right now, Scott McCreary. Hi, Scotty. Say hi to Rex for me as well. Bixby Spartan, but Union employee fans. Is that, did I say that right, Scott? I'm sure you'll let me know. The 1-2 to Pattison coming up. Coming up on 8:30 here Central Time as Patty steps out. He's granted time. Franklin steps off the rubber. And we'll do it again here. The 1-2. That's out to center as well. Right at Hope this time, and there's one away. Left fielder get ready to announce Danzy. We're going to see what coach does here with Franklin on the mound. Talk about how they want to pitch to Danzy on the year. Danzy, a home run threat. Well, I mean, he's as big a threat as we've got. He's got three on the year. We will say this, Danzy is coming in batting about 368. 0-for-3 tonight, though. Left fielder Braylon Danzy. Home run number 4 would be really sweet about right now. Down the middle for a strike, and it's 0-1. The wind has died really to nothing. Talked about that the wind may change direction sometime during this game. We may be in the midst of that happening now, as that's outside 1-1. So Bill Baldridge led off with a double, and Pattison popped out to center. And that's where we are. Got you caught up here in the bottom half of the seventh. Danzy calls time. And he will be granted time. Louisiana dry rule. Let's go, Brent. That misses 2-1. Oh, Scott McCreary, we know you love Union. You and Rex love Union more. We know you do. swinging. Ball gets by. Baldridge scampers down to third.
They're gonna
and Copas is going to argue that he fouled it off. I don't think Danzy got a piece of it. So they're going to have a quick conversation. Blue will get together and talk about it. I don't think Danzy got a piece of that at all. So Baldridge now stands at third. All Danzy needs here is a little base hit. He's got some wheels as well, so you put it in play. Make defense think a little bit, and good things could happen. 2-2, we'll do it again. The 2-2. Outside 3-2. Inside. And the tying run is aboard. Great eyes there by Danzy, and that'll bring in Lane Wood. First baseman Lane Wood. Be interesting to see if they run Danzy here. Franklin's got a much better play to home. Throw to home, I should say. Danzy with a big lead. Let's see if Franklin even looks over. He doesn't. That gets by. Danzy's going to scamper on down, and there we go. So great heads up running there by Danzy. And now the tying run is in scoring position with one away. Lane Wood 1-for-2 tonight. Had a base hit in the second, hit by a pitch in the third, and grounded out in the fifth. The 1-0. A little low. 2-0. I don't think too many people have left the ballpark. A 2-0. Lane Wood with a big cut, and it's 2-1. So Franklin working quickly. Back to the rubber. Gets the sign. Comes home on the ground. That's going to get up the middle. One run will score. They're going to send the runner. The play at the plate. Not in time. And we're tied up again, baby. Absolutely. Lane Wood.
Let's go, Lane.
With a double and two RBIs, and we're knotted at five. And Brown getting extremely aggressive, knowing the kind of arm that Hope had. He didn't have it online. So what they're going to do is they're probably going to courtesy run Fowler for Wood, I would imagine. That's kind of what the talk is up here in the booth.
Dylan, you're so tough.
Pete Knutson thinks he might have broke his hand. Clapping on that. Woo! Hope I moved out of camera because I got a little excited on that one. Courtesy running number 11, Asher Fowler. Now batting number 6, Cody Young. Woo, baby. Yeah, you have preached up the middle quite a bit tonight, Jerry. Cody Young, what can we say about Cody? Cody's 2 for 2. He's got a couple of doubles and a walk. So that's what I'm going to say about Cody Young tonight. One away, Fowler. The winning run at second. Young swinging a hot bat tonight. Ooh, pot foul. It's 0-2. Chance coming from the boys' dugout. The 0-2 delivery. Pop straight back again. Cody wants another one of those. He's ripping them. We talk about a gap right now. There's a huge gap. Right center. Between Hope and Sullivan. Franklin looks back at second, then comes home. It's in the dirt. Interesting if Fowler could have jumped on that. Jerry Jones is saying new.
Hey, you. What a boy, bro.
Didn't know it because if it was lost in his feet or not. Couldn't find it in time.
I'm dead serious, bro. You can laugh all you want, bro.
So Copas will come out and have a quick conversation with Franklin. Blue's not going to let that conversation go very long as he's already trotting out that way.
That's the best sauce there is.
On deck is Zach Oliver. If you're wondering what Zach did tonight, singled. Two RBIs back in the second, grounded out in the third, and then reached on a sacrifice back in the sixth. So, here we go, boys and girls. 1-2 delivery getting ready to come from Franklin. One away. Cody Young, an opportunity to be the hero tonight. Or at least extend this inning. Again, hanging in there, pop foul again. Protecting the plate. That's telling me that Young's seeing the ball really, really well. Pete Knutson's palms are sweaty. I'm just gonna say that right now. I think there's an Eminem song that has that exact line in it. You get royalties off of that, Pete? Okay. Popped up. Infield, and there's two away. The way that thing came off the bat, I thought it was going to be deep, but I don't think it would have advanced Fowler at all. And Zach Oliver steps in. Next up, number three, is Zach Oliver. So Oliver, who's playing second now, started off at third earlier, comes in, first pitch swinging, fouled off. As I said, he had a big hit back in the second, scored two. Grounded out in the third, reached on a sacrifice in the sixth. Franklin steps off the rubber. So Oliver steps out of the box and back in. And again, Franklin steps off the rubber, and again, Oliver steps out of the box. The 0-1 catches the inside of the plate. It's 0-2. Again, Copas out to talk.
Let's go, Ali.
So Franklin, after the conversation with Copas, gets set. Fowler at second. Oliver at the plate. Struck him out. Struck him out. But that's all right. Union ties it. We head to the top of the eighth. We're knotted at five. Back live here, top of the eighth. Not too sure what happened to our scoreboard here. We lost a few things apparently here. So for those of you out there in Union at Red Hawk Land, thanks for staying with us. I guess we had lost our feed earlier. So I appreciate you guys hanging out with us. We are back live. We are in the top of the eighth. Bixby went ahead in there. Half of the seventh, Union came back and tied it in the home half of the seventh, and here we are in the eighth inning. Knutson back on the mound defensively for the Red Hawks. Nothing has changed. Danzy in left, Jones in center, Fluché at right. Gomez at third, Young at short, Oliver at second, Wood at first. And Knutson is 3-0. So Gilliland tonight, 0-for-3, couple of strikeouts and a pop-out. Knutson comes home and it's a strike, 3-1. So it should be 7-8-9. Due up for the Spartans. A 3-1 from Knutson. 3-2. Nice pitch there. Happy Capital fans right now, as Nick's telling me. Capitals are up 1-0. The 3-2 delivery. Swung foul. Just out of play. Joking with my wife earlier. talking about time. She went over and saw the Gray Babies tonight. I had a game, and I said, hey, I'll see you about 10 o'clock. She goes, what are you talking about? I said, well, 2.5 hours for a game, and clean up, and then 45-minute drive home. I said, I'll see you at 10. Well, it's currently 8:45, and there's no end in sight. So, honey, I'll see you tomorrow morning. How about that? What'd you say, Andy? Yeah, yeah. Maybe a late night. Maybe calling my administrative buddies over at 7th grade saying, hey, I might sleep just a little bit later than I normally do. Let's see. So Knuts in the 3-2 delivery. It's popped up. Gomez back. Calls for it, and there's one away. Catcher, number 6, Brock Copas. So Copas checks in. Walked and struck out. So 0 for 1 tonight. First pitch swing and foul. So do it again. Dak Sullivan on deck for the Spartans. The 0-1 out to right, Fluché back, got a track on it, and there's two away. Ben been a busy boy out there tonight. Right fielder, Dak Sullivan. Sullivan, base hit in the third and in the fifth, and then popped out in the seventh, so he's 2 for 3, swinging a pretty good bat tonight for the Spartans. Don't forget, this week here, we will not stream it, but we will have senior night as the boys take on Booker T. 12 seniors in all will be recognized, so we hope you guys can join us here. So that's high and outside, 1-1. No, 2-0, excuse me, 2-0. So we hope to see you guys here, and then if you're not into diamond action, you can head over to the pitch and watch the Jinx Trojan take on the girls at 6 and the boys at 8. That game will be streamed live right here on the Union Sports Network with Nick Irwin. It's on the ground, just foul. It's 2-1. One on the ground, fair ball. Lane Wood comes up with it, and the Spartans go in order, looking to our half here. It'll be top of the order, 1-2-3, as we head to the eighth. Union got a chance. Come on back.
Yeah. If we went to
What more would you want as we head to the eighth? 1, 2, and 3 due up for Union. Leading off for the Redhawks, your center fielder, Gam Jones. As Jones steps in, Franklin back to the bump for the Spartans. First pitch is on the ground. Quickly over. You're going to say he's out. Nice job by Franklin to get his foot down. But there's one away. Pitcher, Camden Knutson. So Knutson came in relief of a great outing by Armando Gomez. Got into a little trouble and Bixby tied it up. Union comes back at the bottom of the seventh, ties it up, and that's why we're here in the bottom of the eighth, 5-5. Inside, 3-0. Now, if you missed any of the game, and I'm going to turn around and look at Andy here, when did we lose our feed? Did they miss any of the exciting stuff that went on? Okay, so you might have missed the bottom of the seventh. You can always go back and look at that. Okay, so what Andy's telling me is that he won't have the opportunity to look and see if we captured that until the game's over. So regardless, we tied it up. I'm just telling you that right now because we're still playing baseball, right? Knutson's on with a walk. That's going to bring in the hot-hitting Ben Flouche. Right fielder Ben Flouche. So hopefully you guys didn't think the game was over and you're still sticking with us. That's going to be get down. Hope's going to cut it off. Knutson's on his horse. He's going to get in there. Knutson channeling his inner Gam Jones, and he gets around safely to third after a double by Ben Flouche. And with one out, the winning run is now 90 feet away. I got to hand it to the home plate umpire for running down there and covering that play at third because it was close. That's going to bring in Dylan Baldridge. Designated hitter, number 5, Dylan Baldridge. They will intentionally walk Baldridge. For the catcher in Pattison. The catcher, number 23, Steven Pattison. So if you've got an eye for the dramatic, they walk Baldridge to get to Pattison. Pattison tonight, he's 1-for-4 with a lone base hit in the fifth. Struck out, popped out, and popped out. One away. Lays down the bunt. The bunt's gone, and it's just foul. Oh, man. Knutson did not stop. As soon as he got into the wine, Knutson was coming home, so that would have been interesting. And the corners look like they're going to crash for Spartan, for the Spartans, I should say. That barely rolled foul. Pattison again. Ah, check swing, strike number 2. So interesting. Now the infielders are back off at the corners just a little bit. Patty knows what he wants to do here. Let's see if he can get it done. Infield is in. Pop foul. Nice piece of swing in there. That all right. Fight it off, kid. We'll do 0-2 again.
Nobody better right here. 2-3. Let's go. 2-3. Right here now. Nobody better, kid. Nobody better. Let's go. 2-3. Let's go. 2-3. Nobody better right here.
So Franklin set up. Ducks on the pond. Patterson waits for the signs. Now he gets time, called by the home plate umpire. Franklin was taking his sweet time getting the sign. The 0-2 popped up. That's a little squibbler. That's going to fall. Fair ball. Ball game. Steven Patterson with a bloop single. And Union will take it, both of them, from the Spartans. And it's pandemonium on the field. Oh, my. Woo! Sorry for blowing your speakers out, folks. Ho, ho, ho! Patterson with a bloop single. And, folks, when you wake up tomorrow, OSSAA will have us in first place in our district, ladies and gentlemen. Union wins it tonight in extras 6-5. Our next broadcast will be Friday night as Nick Irwin brings you Union soccer action as the clubs welcome in the Jinx Trojans to the pitch, the girls at 6, the boys at 8. For our tech, Kyla, producer, director, Andy Irwin, I'm Jim Dowd. Oh, baby. Have a fabulous evening. Good night, everybody.